The muscle of NASCAR has arrived at Edmonton International Raceway for round number 6 of the 2016 NASCAR Pinty Series. 18 competitors are ready for the main event as the season reaches the midway point. Last week, it was the streets of Toronto. Since then, competitors have traveled across the prairies and stopped at the foot of the Rocky Mountains. We're in Wetaskiwin, Alberta, for the Alberta Has New Energy 300.
And welcome to the mid-season Western Swing. Edmonton International Raceway will act as our host for the next 300 laps. I'm Dave Bradley, along with the voice of NASCAR in Canada, Adam Ross, and Todd Lewis is handling the trackside duties. Adam, this is a tight quarter mile that Ron and Loretta Thiering have here.
Dave, there's not a lot of banking. Every one of these 18 drivers know the inside groove is the place to be, and they're going to fight to get to the bottom of the racetrack.
And you'll see a number of Western Series drivers joining the Pinty Series at this event. The 53 of Noel Dowler, one of 6 drivers in the show tonight. And there you can see a lot of BC Alberta drivers joining the field.
Great to see the local contingent come out to really support this event, Dave.
And the young guns, too. There's a good look at Riley Siebert, set to go 300 laps here today. Last week in Toronto, though, Alex Tagliani took his second win of the season, and that win has him sitting fourth in the Pinty Series point standings. But what a dice it was with Andrew Ranger and Kevin Lacroix all race long.
It was an epic battle in Toronto, as we see an all-Quebec podium. They've made the trip all the way across the country, and it's Andrew Ranger with a 13-point lead over Caden Lapcevich, the 16-year-old in the 76.
And that second place is actually a battle of two rookies, Caden Lapcevich and Kevin Lacroix, sitting second and third. Ian Admiral getting strapped in his 83. You can see the front row getting all set to go. Let's check in with Todd. Todd?
Guys, the front row is the rookie battle. In their first visits to Edmonton, surprises on the front row. Kevin Lacroix in the 74 gets his first career pole. Of course, he's got 2 road course victories. He'd love to have an oval victory as well. He circled this quarter mile track in a 12.901 second time. A quick time. He's hoping for 300 good laps tonight. Alongside on the front row, well, he has been on the front row for all of the oval races this season. It's 16-year-old Caden Lapcevich in the 76. As I mentioned, also his first visit to Edmonton. He's had 2 second place finishes. His dad won in Edmonton on the road course a decade ago. He'd love to have his first career victory here on the oval tonight. Let's go back up the track and get the race started with the command to fire engines.
Engines come to life here in sleepy Wetaskiwin, Alberta. We'll have a number of great onboard shots, including the 69 of Riley Siebert, the number 3 of Jason Hathaway as he tightens his gloves, the 56 of Kelly Admiral making a start here today.
Kelly Admiral going to run both Western Swing races in the number 56 owned by Jim Bray. Great to see both the Admiral brothers racing in our series together.
And the field set to roll off. We'll take a look at your clean flow starting lineup. There is your all-rookie front row, Lacroix Lapcevich. Row number 2 has the 02 of Mark Dilley and the 18 of Alex Tagliani.
Back to the third row, we have the 47 LP Dumoulin and the 27 Andrew Ranger. In row number 4, Jamie Krizik behind the wheel of the 09 and Kelly Admiral in the 56.
Taking a look back to row number 5, there is Noel Dowler in the 53, Riley Siebert, couple young guns. And there's DJ Kennington in the 17 and Gary Klute in the 59, that's row 6.
Row number 7, Larry Jackson behind the wheel of the number 25, and there's Jason Hathaway, will be on board with him tonight. Joey McComb in the Canada's Best Racing Team number 1, and Jason Hankowicz in the 9.
Ian Admiral drives the 83 Dodge, and Alex LeBay in the 32, starting shotgun on the field in the 4.
There are stories all through this field, Dave, but Alex LeBay with his work cut out for him, starting from the back.
Very much so, and before we get things underway, let's take a look at the E3 Spark Plugs race analysis, 300 laps, 75 miles.
It's a halfway break race, so around the midway point of the race, they'll all come down pit road, take on tires and fuel, and the defending winner, Scott Steckley, not here to defend his win.
Before we get things underway, let's check in with Todd for our Leland lead up to the green. Todd?
Guys, looking forward to watching the Western drivers tonight, including Jamie Krishek, who is the highest qualifying Western driver. He's had some troubles here at Edmonton in the past. He's hoping to complete all 300 tonight. Also keep an eye on the 32 of Alex LaBey. Decided to change motors before qualifying, didn't turn a lap. He's out there now starting shotgun. They wanted a fresh one because the one they had in there, he said, just wasn't running properly.
And Dave, you know what's fun about the Western Swing? One of the first people under the car to help LaBey work on it was driver the number 25, Larry Jackson.
And that's cool. All these drivers pull together. Everybody helps each other out because you're a long way from home. A lot of them are. Some of them are very close to home, including the Western drivers making their start. Well, the field lines up side by side, door handle to door handle. We look for green in the Alberta Has New Energy 300 at Edmonton International Raceway. It's Kevin Lacroix in the 74, Caden Lapcevich in the 76, and we are underway.
This is new territory for him. His first career pole position. He gets a great launch at the green flag.
Just watch how they settle in. Lapcevich up on the outside quickly slides backwards.
The outside groove is such a hard place to make work here. And we see Caden Lapcevich. He's pedaling as hard as he can. But the inside groove is where it's at. Mark Dilley right down on that yellow line.
Mark Dilley knows all about that inside groove as he's working the back bumper of the 74 of Kevin Lacroix. The Leland Industries 024. A solid second in the early going.
Our most experienced oval track racer in Mark Dilley, and probably our least experienced oval track racer in Kevin Lacroix, duking it out for the lead.
And you see how smooth this track surface is. You can see the driver's hands not really bouncing around too much. This place repaved in 2014. So Lacroix grabs a handful of wheel and he'll lose the lead. Dilley through to the top spot.
Turn three is the really challenging part of this track. We saw DJ Kennington even struggle in qualifying. Overshot the corner, you get up out of the groove, and it takes a long time to get control back of your race car.
And here comes Caden Lapcevich digging underneath the total lubricants, number 74 of Kevin Lacroix. Lacroix has things settled back down, running in second spot. But Lapcevich in the fast line motorsports, number 76, holding third.
And we go on board with this 16-year-old Lapcevich. I can't stress that enough. Unbelievable. A little bit of contact with Lacroix as Lapcevich works the inside groove.
That's just a veteran short track move from a rookie as he bumps the 74 up out of the way. Not hard enough to turn him, just to move him as Caden Lapcevich makes a pitch for second.
And Dave, you were right when you said it's a smooth, smooth racetrack. But the one place there is a bump, that yellow stripe on the bottom of the track, you want to be right on that stripe. If you go over it, it'll bounce the car right up into the car in the outside lane.
Riding on board your points leader in the Mopar Dodge, Andrew Ranger. Now he rubs a little bit with the 74 of Kevin Lacroix. The WeatherTech Dodge, the 47 of LP Dumoulin, has managed to pick up a spot in that melee as well.
Contact between Tagliani and the 18 and the 74 of Lacroix. Both of those drivers gathered it in.
Tough to make it stick up on the high groove though here, isn't it?
It's just not a long-term solution. You get up in the high groove, you've got a short-term problem. You want to find the first opening to get back to the bottom.
Well, that's what you saw with Kevin Lacroix as he lost a number of positions. Running second early on, now finds himself deep inside the top 10 as we ride on board Gary Clute very quickly in the 59.
Gary Clute deeper in the field than he'd like to be, but that's a testament to the quality of the field. Look at that, Noel Dowler closing the door on DJ Kennington. Little bit of contact made, just like you said, that's short track racing, Dave.
That's it, and that's the way to get by. Here's the Empire Mechanical, number 53, slides up the racetrack. DJ Kennington can't seal the deal as the door closes and the Castrol Edge Dodge will stay in behind.
Even in practice, Kennington looks to have a very drivable car, as we've got one of the Admirals around. The 56 of Kelly Admiral loops it in turn number two.
The OMVIC-sponsored number 56 Dodge of Kelly Admiral will bring out the first caution here at Edmonton International Raceway. Have another look.
Towards the back of the field, Admiral in a battle with Jason Hankowicz. And there you see a little bit of contact between Hankowicz and the 9 and the 56 of Admiral. Around he goes.
It's a short track, but it's pretty wide, so Admiral avoids the wall, which is great. But it slows the field. First time under caution for the day. Mark Dilley is your race leader. This NASCAR on TSN telecast from Wetaskiwin, Alberta is brought to you by WeatherTech, the ultimate interior protection for your vehicle. By Mopar, authentic performance. And by Pinty's, making great food fun.
Back here a little bit, we're starting to reel them in. Coming back to green here, lap 22. Get ready.
Ready.
Getting set for the first restart of the afternoon. Mark Dilley will lead him to green here on the front stretch. He'll have Caden Lapcevich alongside heading into turn one.
And we're going to see this all night long on the restarts. The car's on the outside. Whoa. Looking for the inside, and we've got contact for the lead.
That might be a little bit more than a short track move as Caden Lapcevich making big contact with the Johnsonville 0-2 of Mark Dilley.
And what he did also, look at the right front tire of Lapcevich now exposed. That really makes him vulnerable to cutting down a tire, messing up the alignment of the front end, Dave.
And it makes the 0-2 vulnerable for cutting down a tire as well. The Leland Industries Ford Fusion still hanging on in second as we have a battle a little bit deeper in the field. The 74 of Lacroix alongside your points leader, the 27 of Andrew Ranger for fourth spot.
Kevin Lacroix doing a great job in that 74. Let's remember, his crew chief is five-time NASCAR champion Don Thompson Jr. He knows what he's doing, calling shots from the pit box.
About Noel Dowler there pushing the 27 of Ranger, a two-time series champion, up out of the groove, and the Empire Mechanical number 53 will slide through. Noel Dowler is not new to this series. He's run a couple full-time efforts in the NASCAR Pinty series in years gone by. He's just running pick and choose events here this year, but he knows how to get it done.
Let's have another look at this pass for the lead. Lapcevich tried to go up the inside, just didn't quite have enough room to make that move. Contact with Dilley. And let's see if Mark Dilley holds a grudge. He's not the type of driver to really push it, but Lapcevich there gets hot into turn three.
Yeah, Lapcevich just did it to himself. He dove in too hot, maybe looking in his rearview mirror, thinking payback might be coming, but Dilley handed the lead.
Dilley is one of the mentors for Caden Lapcevich as he's come up through the stock car ranks, so I think they'll shake that off pretty quickly.
Mark Dilley, a promoter at Sunset Speedway, and that's where Caden Lapcevich cut his racing teeth. In a super stock and now drives a late model there on occasion. And of course, the driver, the number 76 here in the NASCAR Pinty Series, is good old DJ Kennington. The Castrol Edge Dodge gives his teammate a little bump.
Yeah, a couple of teams that travel together, both worked on out of the St. Thomas shops of DJ Kennington. The 17 of Kennington, the 27 of Ranger. And here comes Alex LeBay. Let's remember, he started dead last after an engine change between practice and the race.
The Can-Am Kappa Ford Fusion is on a move. That engine, not fast enough. This one seems to be. He's already up to ninth.
Look at the position of his head. I noticed that earlier on in the ovals. It looks like they've got the seat position to keep the head in a spot where the driver can really be comfortable navigating the turns.
Riding on board the Ray Vestas Brakes Fast Eddie Racewear, number 3 of Jason Hathaway, sitting in 12th spot. Bit of a struggle for that driver, is expected to contend for a win here, and we've got contact again. Kennington giving the one of Joey McComb a little push.
Just tickling the rear bumper of Joey McComb to get him up out of the groove. And look at that, it opens the door for Kennington. Now LeBay, it could be a long ride on the outside for Joey McComb.
We can see the lineup of traffic on the inside, and that's normally what happens. You get up on the outside and you try and make it work, but you really have to force your way back down. You see the 09 of Jamie Krizak now moving to the inside of the one.
And I love seeing these series part-timers and series regulars. That's Jason Hathaway. He's run every race since the series began, running right behind Jamie Krizak, who still only has a handful of starts to his credit.
But you know what? They have nothing to lose. They're going for a race win as Hathaway gets to the inside of Krizak, and now Krizak in that outside group, but Hathaway up to 10th spot now.
And we can still see Joey McComb losing positions, and now we've got a battle for the lead once again. Caden Lapcevich working the inside groove. Mark Dilley leaving that bottom open for Lapcevich to try there.
Maybe the tires not working as good as they were a little bit earlier on the Leland Ford Fusion of Mark Dilley, as here comes the youngster, Caden Lapcevich, just 16 years old, looking for the lead once again here in Edmonton.
Part of that is the veteran nature of Mark Dilley. If you know you've got a hungry driver behind you, there's no point in staying on the bottom and getting knocked out of the groove when you can sort of control your own destiny by running that one groove up the racetrack and hang in there like he is, but not use up his equipment.
on board from the bumper-to-bumper, number 74 of Kevin Lacroix, looking forward to the WeatherTech Dodge, the 47 of LP Dumoulin, and this has to be one of his best races so far of the year. But you know what? You had to see this one coming. That 47 team, very, very quick when they make trips out west. He is back-to-back, top fives, 2 second place finishes here in Edmonton.
One car on pit road. That's the 83 Swan Rentals machine of Ian Admiral. And he is just limping down pit road, Dave.
No caution, though. We'll stay under green in this battle for third spot now as Lacroix gets into the back of Dumoulin looking for second. Lacroix was battling with Dilly, and all of a sudden now he's up to Dumoulin, and here comes Tagliani in there in the EpiPen Chevy.
And Todd Lewis is on pit road with a report from the 83.
Crew is having a look near the right front of that 83 car, guys. They're also looking at the right rear, but no real rush. This might be a terminal problem.
Yeah, the fact that they're not hustling. If there's a flat tire, you know where there's a flat tire. It sounded like that car was dead in the water. Nobody in a hurry. Might be an early exit for Admiral.
And you saw it roll forward as it hit its pit stall as well. But Admiral sits on pit lane as Alex Tagliani picks up a spot underneath the 74 of Kevin Lacroix. You can see those battle scars starting to form on some of these cars. That fender on the left front of the bumper-to-bumper, number 74 of Lacroix, sticking well up in the air.
We ride on board the Leland Industries number 024 to Mark Dilley in the fifth position, and he's lost some spots, but as you say, not a mark on that Ford Fusion of Dilley. He knows how to get to the end of these races, and he knows how to work the front bumper when the opportunity arises.
He may have a mark on the front of that car at this point now, but you just have to keep your momentum up here. There's not a long straightaway. You're in a corner pretty much for three quarters of it.
And the reason that happened, they're working through lap traffic. The 25 of Larry Jackson's gone a lap down. You saw that Tagliani had gotten by, but Kevin Lacroix couldn't make his way past Larry Jackson just yet.
This is one and two. Caden Lapcevich in the 47 of LB Dumoulin. And this is a battle for fifth spot as Kennington looks underneath the 0-2 of Dilly.
A unique view from the back bumper of the 74 of Kevin Lacroix.
Down the front straightaway, Kennington still underneath the 0-2. We got problems, and it's the 0-9 who goes around. This is going to draw a caution as Jamie Krizic to the inside of turn number four.
Man, he was having a good run, Dave. Got turned around backwards and forth. Doesn't look like he hit anything, and he's got the car running, but he has gone a lap down.
Almost in front of his teammate as he pulls back on track. We'll have another look back from the three of Hathaway.
The hole was there for a moment, but not for long, and Jason Hathaway is on pit road.
A handling adjustment for the three of Jason Hathaway. They've been struggling with that car a little bit all day long. He's making a stop and hoping it'll be better now that they've returned to green.
You can see the Goodyears rubbed off the right front tire on the Fast Eddie Racewear, number three of Hathaway, as he'll find his spot in the lineup. Your leader continues to be the rookie Lapcevich. Getting set for the restart, the number 25 of Larry Jackson, who comes into this event ninth in points, getting the free pass during that last caution, but it's Lapcevich who will lead him off four and back to green.
And we see that inside lane again, getting a huge jump on the start. Lapcevich out in front, now Tagliani trying to get through and by LP Dumoulin as well.
And this is really now a situation that benefits the EpiPen Chevy of Alex Tagliani, who currently sits second. You see the yellow and black, and now he's going for the lead. Tagliani giving the 76 of Lapcevich a little shove, and now he goes through to the top spot. But a run where your tires get a little bit worn and the track gets a little bit slick, that really suits Alex Tagliani.
And Lapcevich losing a few spots. There's Mark Dilley, the KG veteran, in second. And look at Alex LeBay from 18th. He's now battling for third.
And LeBay has won on another track about as short as this one at Autodrome Chaudière, picking up his very first NASCAR Pinty Series win here in 2016.
We ride on board both Lapcevich and the 32 of Alex LeBay. What a great view.
And you can see the cars just easing their way through. Now Hathaway trying to work his way back up after making that pit stop for some handling adjustments, working to the inside of the 17 of Kennington.
And we had a good look at the 69 of Riley Siebert making his return to the series. Great to see the Siebert family back in action.
It's a battle for 11th spot on the speedway. On board now with Hathaway. And it seems as though the adjustment did do something. It looks like that number three car is handling just a little bit better. His hands not moving too much as they were earlier in the race.
No, I think you're absolutely right. As we look at the top four, things have settled down just a little bit. Tagliani leads the way.
Oh, big problems. You can see it in turn number four at the top of your screen. The number nine and the 09 get together again, and they're trying to get going in front of the leader. Tagliani nearly stops on the track, obviously under caution now, as both drivers get going, but wow.
Here's a great illustration. A couple of part-time racers, Jamie Krizik and Jason Hankowicz, behind the wheel of the number nine. But even as part-timers, they know, don't look at what's coming. Put the hammer down and don't lose another lap.
Welcome back to race number six. The Alberta has new energy 300 for the NASCAR Pinty Series. We're in Wetaskiwin, Alberta. I'm Dave Bradley. Along with me in the booth is Adam Ross. Todd Lewis is trackside, and Alex Tagliani is leading the field back to green.
He looks pretty good there out front. Gets another great start, but Mark Dilley does a nice job to get down to the bottom. Caden Lapsevich trying to get to the inside, but Dilley will hang on to the second spot.
So they're even hanging out there, man.
That's the voice of young Steven Simmons, the new spotter this year for Andrew Ranger from Cambridge, Ontario. Doing a great job so far this season. Two wins.
On board Alex LeBay, and a bit of a hit there from the 76 of Caden Lapsford. We got problems. The three car of Jason Hathaway makes contact with the outside wall.
Oh, and Hathaway just limping around the racetrack in that Raybestos number three. Big problems for that car.
You saw a flash of him as he's looking for pit lane. There he finds it, but you're right. Huge damage to the right front corner. Have another look.
They come out of turn four, Hathaway deep in the field. Oh, he got both ends. When you get the right rear corner first, let's go on board with Hathaway. Let's listen to this, Dave.
Lots of damage on that right front, the flat tire, of course, but now the crew surveying underneath to see what other suspension and other damage they may have to repair before they can send that three car back out.
There's a team with absolutely no luck so far in 2016. They were thought to be a contender for the championship. Dilley grabs a whole bunch of wheel in the 0-2 as Caden Lapsevich sports by on the inside. That's about for a second.
Battle for the second spot. Indeed, big problems ahead. Alex LeBay makes contact with Kevin Lacroix. There's body panels flying everywhere.
And that is going to draw the caution. You saw all kinds of debris on the racetrack. A lot of it coming from the Can-Am Kappa Ford Fusion of Alex LeBay, and he's not happy.
Oh, neither is Kevin Lacroix.
Keep your hands in the car, Alex LeBay. You never know what's going to happen as Kevin Lacroix rubs during caution. Let's see what started this.
So LeBay up on the outside. Oh, right front into the left rear. And Dave, when you get tire-to-tire contact like that, these cars get way squirrely.
Now on board, Alex LeBay. Here comes Kevin Lacroix. Wasn't a hard hit.
Once you get that tire on tire, you can rub fenders, you can bump with these cars, but once the tire hits another tire, it really upsets the race cars.
Larry Jackson in the Pilotti number 25 down pit lane. He's getting some adjustments as we near the halfway mark. We're hearing from NASCAR that they may move up that mid-race break.
Once they do that, Dave, all the cars will come down pit road and make their adjustments. But let's have a look at some of the action we've seen tonight.
And there has been lots on this tight quarter of a mile oval, but the Edmonton International Raceway in Wetaskiwin, Alberta, big supporters of the NASCAR brand. They've been a NASCAR home track since 2005, but pit lane is the busy place right now. You can see every car on the racetrack is filed down into their pit stall, and that's where we will find our very own Todd Lewis. Todd?
Now the mid-race pit stops. The 18 team will make a very minor tire change. Alex Tagliani out front of the car. He's very happy. Directly behind him, the 76 of Caden Lapsevich. Had a bit of a battle. You can see a little bit of hood damage with some contact out on the track. Caden said to his dad, Jeff, yeah, I kind of messed up a little bit, but he's handling himself really well again. Very minor adjustments to that 76.
You can see some adjustments going on. The 27 of Andrew Ranger. New tires for the 17 of DJ Kennington.
And we'll be back with the second half of Alberta Has New Energy 300.
Welcome back to the Wild West at Edmonton International Raceway for the NASCAR Pinty Series on TSN. Cars back on track, and it's the 18 of Alex Taglieni alongside the 76 of Caden Lapcevich getting set for the restart. After the halfway break, Sean Gibbs waves the green. We're back underway.
Once again, Alex Taglieni with a huge restart on the bottom as Caden Lapcevich slams the door on Mark Dilley getting back to the bottom.
Well, it's that aggressive move to get to the bottom. You can't afford to be up in the outside groove, but now Lapcevich slides up on his own. Here comes Dilley.
Mark Dilley on the bottom of the racetrack. Andrew Ranger not going to let opportunity pass him by. He's down in the bottom groove as well.
So Andrew Ranger in the Mopar Dodge sits now in third spot. He is your points leader coming into this event. There's Joey McComb in the number one, the CBRT Ford Fusion up on the outside.
Riley Siebert in the 69. Right up to the door, Joey McComb as they battle for the eighth position.
You remember seeing that 69 car at Sunset Speedway in the second race of the season. Trevor Siebert drove that one. That's Riley's father drove that at Sunset.
Well, and the plan is for Riley Siebert to race here tonight, and then next Wednesday in Saskatoon, Trevor Siebert going to climb behind the wheel.
Share and share alike. You see a lot of duct tape now on the front of the 32 Can-Am Ford Fusion of Alex LaBay as he chases the 53 of Noel Dowling.
That's a pretty cool look for Alex LaBay. That's a menacing looking front end.
A little bit of Mad Max going on there. A good look at Gary Clute, and now Clute has company, and it's Siebert over the hood.
Oh, and Noel Dowler might have just gotten the worst of that.
Oh, this is a big one here at Edmonton International Raceway.
You know, opportunity doesn't always knock for a long time. Gary Clute, the opening was there. Looked like Riley Siebert went through it, but then the door shut. Then all hell broke loose, Steve.
It really did. Jason Hankowicz in the 9 also involved. You saw the 53 of Noel Dowling. Have another look.
Keep going.
I'm curious whose radio we were listening to there. So there's Gary Clute knocked sideways. Riley Siebert launches over the front end.
Anytime you can see the underside of a car, it is not a good day, but Clute is in. Todd, what's up?
Clearing the bodywork, the first job. Now they want to check and examine what sort of damage is done underneath. Suspension and handling and brakes. They want to make sure those are working before Gary Clute returns to the fight.
We ride on board with Riley Siebert. There you see the opening is there. Clute starts to slide down the racetrack. The Siebert family is big into flying, Dave.
Yeah, but that second hit, too, looks like it was the one that did in the 69 as Riley Siebert gets pushed back to his pit. So the debris cleaned up, and we look to get things back underway. It is still Alex Taglieni in the EpiPen Cantor, number 18. He's got Mark Dilley, and they're rubbing each other through turn number 4 as we get back to green.
Well, Taglieni holding Dilley about 3 lanes up the racetrack from where he would normally be. Gives him a great launch on the start as Andrew Ranger looking for the second position.
And we can tell you, too, an update from the pits, the 53 of Noel Dowler, the Empire Mechanical Dodge. He is out, so his night ends early.
Heavy damage on the front end. We could see the radiator punched out of that car, so tough night for Noel Dowler.
On board, the number 27 of Andrew Ranger as he chases the 18 of Alex Taglieni.
Remember, Ranger leading the NASCAR Pinty Series point standings for most of this race. He's been behind second place Caden Lapcevich, but now Andrew Ranger in a great position to have a good run.
There's a battle there for seventh between the 32 of Alex LaBay and the number 1 of Joey McComb. McComb making a little contact, but LaBay hanging on.
You know, Dave, one of my favorite things about our races is we watch these cars beating and banging on each other. You will never hear the term aero push in a NASCAR Pinty Series race. The bodies look nice, but they're not as functional as what you see out of the higher NASCAR series.
And especially on a track like this, a quarter-mile bull ring, and this is what it is. It's old-school short-track stock car racing, and that's what draws these fans to Edmonton International Raceway.
The sun is playing on these race cars as we watch DJ Kennington battling for the fifth spot with LP Dumoulin.
And LeBay even with all he's had to deal with here today, starting at the back, getting involved with the 74 in a melee. You see the fender all taped up. He's now well up inside the top 10, battling for the top 5.
As long as your four tires are still pointing in the same direction, you've got a shot to be competitive.
And we're hearing up some debris in turn number 4 as LeBay battles with a 17 of DJ Kennington. And that will draw the caution, and we got problems on the front straightaway.
Kelly Admiral checked up for the yellow flag just a little bit quicker than the car behind him. He goes around, but no contact was made.
Welcome back to the Alberta Has New Energy 300 near Edmonton, Alberta. And we did go back to green for a short period of time, but we had another problem.
As they come out of turn number 2, you see Caden Lazarus working to get to the bottom.
Oh, and there was big problems there. You see the 9 and the 09, along with the 1 of Joey McComb. McComb actually got a little airborne there for a second.
Yeah, another car jumping up over a rear tire of the car in front of him.
We're supposed to have fenders. That's not supposed to happen.
You're not kidding. We're about to see another restart. Tagling Annie on the inside. Andrew Ranger on the outside.
Now remember, Andrew Ranger, one of the drivers who has won here already, the only active driver here today who's been to victory lane at Edmonton International Raceway. A little wiggle there as Mark Dilley takes a look underneath.
2 years ago, it was Alex Tagliani who led the entire first half of the race, but Andrew Ranger stalked him and made the pass. I will say this, Tagliani's car looks much better tonight than it did 2 years ago.
Oh, very much so. There you see a quick flash of the 74 of Kevin Lacroix battling alongside fellow rookie, the 76, for fifth spot. Caden Lapsevich to the inside, but have to give a hats off to the 74 team. Back-to-back third-place finishes coming into this one.
Yeah, they're definitely running a streak of solid results, and he's having a good run so far tonight.
Good battle here between DJ Kennington and the Northern Provincial Pipeline's number 17 and the 02 of Mark Dilley in the Leyland Industries Ford Fusion.
I think we're seeing the calm before the storm here, Dave. Things have settled down just a touch as we look at Gary Klute battling for the ninth spot with a 56 of Kelly Admiral.
On board Klute, who sits in ninth position, and two cars that have really been through the ringer here today. The 59 of Klute has actually been driven over, but he's still going.
These cars are durable, that's for sure. One thing we should make note of as we see the different camera angles, the Thierings, Ron and Loretta, have put two new grandstands in turn number 4. One of them not quite ready for fans yet, but the other one half full, and the main grandstand is filled to the gills.
And you see that spotter stand in turn number 1. It's well up in the air. It gives the spotters a great view of this entire surface, so they can really give their drivers the best opportunity to win.
It's a unique facility, constantly making improvements. Every year, we see a few new additions to the surroundings.
Yeah, they never really sit still as we ride on board. Caden Lapsevich now on the back bumper, and we got more problems. And again, it's the 1 of Joey McComb, the 74 of Kevin Lacroix. This is off of turn number 4. Caution, obviously, out once again.
We'll have a look at the replay from onboard Kevin Lacroix. Little bit of contact. Joey McComb wasn't the first contact there, but again, another car up in the air.
And Lacroix gets the worst of this one, and it looks like he is done. They will push that car behind the wall. Under caution once again here in Wetaskiwin, Alberta. Tagliani's your leader. Welcome back to NASCAR on TSN in the 6th race of the NASCAR Pinty Series. Getting set for a restart here on lap 204. Alex Tagliani leads him back to green.
All clear. Inside 17. All inside. Back inside 17.
Again, listening to Steven Simmons, the spotter for the 27. It was curious to hear. He tells them where the car is and that it's his teammate, DJ Kennington. Inside 17.
Whoa, there's Ranger making hard contact with the 02. Ranger trying to make a big move to the inside. Now he'll find the hole he needs, getting out of that upper groove.
And immediately go chose to work on the rear bumper of the Mark Dilley number 02.
Remember, Andrew Ranger cut his racing teeth in the open wheel world. He really took to these short track ovals very, very quickly in his NASCAR career. He loves bumping and grinding.
He does now. He really did well at first, but he didn't like it. If you remember, in 2007, he had stickers of bumper cars on his helmet when they raced at Barry Speedway.
That was always a very interesting place when the NASCAR Pinty Series made a stop at Barry, but this track is very reminiscent of that facility. It's tight, it's fast, it's aggressive.
Very physical racing. You've got to be prepared to be bumped. You know you're going to use your bumper a little bit, but it's the driver who can handle being knocked around a few times. Keep your cool, keep trying to move forward.
On board the 02 of Mark Dilley, as he was just a driver bumped up out of the way, but he settles back in behind the 27. Now you take a look back at the 59 of Gary Klute sitting in ninth spot. 76 of Lapsevich just behind him.
And Caden Lapsevich got knocked way out of the groove, lost a number of positions. Now let's see if the youngster can win them back.
On the inside, you see the damage to the back end of the Dodge Challenger of Lapsevich.
What the spotter's going to try to do, you might think it's redundant. Still inside, still inside. But as soon as he sees an opening, okay, clear behind the 59. And that's what the driver knows. Hard left, get back to the bottom.
That spotter is Gary's father, Peter Klute, who's up on the stand trying to coach his son through a very tight race here. And now he will give him that clear as he'll fall in behind the 32 of Alex LeBay.
And Peter Klute, a very good race car driver in his own right.
Very much so. And he's got a couple fast sons in Ryan and Gary Klute, both of whom we've seen in the NASCAR Pinty Series already this year. You can tell it's getting down to the end of this race because the driver's not quite as aggressive on the throttle as they once were. Caden Lapsevich up to sixth spot, but he's babying that thing.
The tires are getting old. You've really got to be cautious on the throttle. I was curious to see. It looks as though the sun no longer a factor.
And there is your race leader. Alex Taglianni continues to pace the field, now opening up a bit of a gap over your second place runner, the 02 of Mark Dilley.
Right with you.
Just like we mentioned, not only will Steven tell him who's inside of him, but he's going to tell him what to expect for basically the next lap or so.
You can expect contact. It's coming.
Now we ride on board the Area 27 sponsored Riley Siebert.
Riley Siebert's going to let the 27 down behind the 76 of Caden Lapsevich, but there was contact between Dumoulin, between Lapsevich and Ranger. Everybody shoving each other around looking for a spot, but Taglianni has that spot. He is your race leader. We continue under green with Alex Taglianni in the lead, and the Alberta has new energy 300 at Edmonton International Raceway on TSN. 42 laps remain here of a scheduled 300, and the action is picking up.
Caden Lapsevich working the inside of Mark Dilley in the Leland number 02. That's a battle for fourth.
The 02 car is still relatively clean through this real bump and grind affair. You can see Lapsevich's body panels hanging off, but Dilley's car seems to be still in one piece.
Well, let's remember, it's not a long turnaround between this race tonight until we race again in Saskatoon.
That's the beauty of this Western swing, is the drivers get a lot of races in. Unfortunately for the crews, they have to fix a lot of cars in between.
What a great battle we're seeing. Jamie Krizek in the 09 just got around Gary Klute for the ninth position. He's right in front of race leader Alex Taglianni, but Tags has not been able to catch him.
Well, Krizek is picking up the pace to stay in front of the leader, and it seems to be working. He's also picking up positions. Good look at the 27 of Andrew Ranger battling with the 32 of Alex LeBay.
The lap's winding down, and these drivers know it. It's go time. They're up on the wheel. The belts are tight, and they've got to start digging for all they're worth.
Alex Taglianni continues to lead the Riobel, EpiPen, Cantorque, Chevy Impala. He's got a comfortable margin now at the front of the field. So once he's working lap traffic, he can afford to take a little bit of a break and not make those risky moves.
He's got enough of a lead right now, Tagliani can afford to make those decisions. But here's a battle for the second spot. DJ Kennington looking to rebound from a miserable run in Toronto where mechanical failure knocked him out of that race.
You know what? We'll loop both drivers into that rebound needed here in Edmonton. LP Dumoulin hasn't had the start to the 2016 season that he wanted behind the wheel of that WeatherTech.ca Dodge. On board, Mark Dilley in the Leland Industries 0-2, working the back bumper, the 76 of young Caden Lapcevich.
He's trying to get close enough, but he can't quite get there. About half a car length between the 76 and the 0-2, and I'm not sure if Dilley can get close enough to use that bumper.
It's a battle for fourth spot, so you know he will if he gets the opportunity to. But for Caden Lapcevich, this is a big opportunity in the Johnston's Rookie of the Year battle. The 74th, Kevin Lacroix, out of this race early. So Lapcevich stands to build a lot of points in that battle.
10 laps to go, and we've got another battle. Jamie Krizek continues to work through the field. He's passed Alex LeBay, and now he's gone by Andrew Ranger.
Sixth spot for Jamie Krizek in the 0-9, and the driver, that Dodge Challenger, is on the move.
He's given that car a heck of a run. We see the green duct tape, some battle scars, but it's not slowing him down one bit.
You can see there is your race leader, continues to work into lap traffic. The 32 of Alex LeBay just ahead of the driver, the EpiPen Chevy.
Problems for second place DJ Kennington. He is slow on the backstretch.
Blew up. That's crazy.
DJ Kennington, who was having that rebound run he needed, will now find pit lane. But it looks like his night will end a lot sooner than he wanted it to. He rolls to his pit lane, the crew not even ready to accept him.
Just 7 laps to go, and Kennington was having a great race.
No caution. We stay under green, and Alex Tagliani continues to lead. 5 laps to go.
5 laps remaining, and Dave, Tag's doing something really cool this year. It started at the Toronto Indy. It's called the Summer of Tags. They're going around accepting cash donations and allergy-friendly food donations. Tagliani, always with an EpiPen on hand and a big advocate for that sort of thing. Great to see them raising that sort of awareness.
Has been for a couple of years now in the Nascar Pinty series. And as he leads, we are watching one driver who is streaking through the field. The 0-9 of Jamie Krizek is on the move. He is coming. Watch him as he flashes into your screen right now, working on the 0-2 of Mark Dilley.
Looking to have a fourth place result for team owner Trevor Siebert. That'd be a great run for the 0-9 crew.
Looking to the inside that time by Mark Dilley. Now slides up the racetrack. Here comes Krizek on the inside.
On old tires, I can't believe the run he's getting on the bottom. 1 lap to go.
And Tagliani has this one well in hand out in front, but it's Krizek and Dilley battling side by side for fourth. The 0-9 on the inside, but we'll watch the 18. Tagliani's going to win his second of the season.
Tagliani with the win. LP Dumoulin second, Caden Lapcevich third, and here's your race for fourth.
Fourth spot will go to Jamie Krizek. What a drive for that driver as he comes home inside the top five.
And the EpiPen team celebrates on pit road.
43-year-old Canadian Motorsport Hall of Famer Alex Tagliani is back in victory lane, this time here in Edmonton.
For the second week in a row, and for the third time this season, Alex Tagliani is climbing out of that number 18 car to wave the checkered flag and accept congratulations as the race winner. Alex Tagliani, it was lots of caution in the middle of the race. You told me before that if you had a long green flag run, you thought you'd be really good. That's what you got at the end of this race.
Let me tell you something. Look at this guy. These guys are the reason why we're here. you know, the 22 racing team is amazing. Obviously, Scott now out of the car is really overlooking everything, and I'm learning from him a lot, actually. He won this race last year, so there was no reason why we couldn't do it with his help. And then Tyler and the whole team, the boys, are just doing amazing right now. So, yeah, what can we say? The EpiPen car is good, and thanks to everybody here is doing a fantastic job.
Alex Tagliani, third win of the season, really tightening up that points battle.
And here comes car owner Colin Livingston in for a hug and a well-deserved one. Let's take a look at the top 10. Jamie Krizek, as we mentioned, from a full lap down up to fourth.
And how about Kelly Admiral with an eighth place result in that 56?
Gary Klute will salvage a nine. DJ Kennington still 10th place here today. Let's go back down to Taco Todd.
LP Dumoulin for the third year in a row up on the podium here at Edmonton.
Feels great for the weather at the Benmar team. I mean, everybody worked really hard yesterday to change engines in the car. Here we go today. We showed up, and the car was performing really on the long run. Very happy for the team. Let's keep it up because the season's still long.
Good to see that driver smiling. They needed this second place run. We'll take a look at the point standings. A big drop for the 74 of Kevin Lacroix, goes all the way down to fifth.
All the way down to fifth, Tagliani up to third, and a driver who closed in a few points on leader Andrew Ranger is with Todd Lewis.
Started on the front row again here at this oval in Edmonton. Caden Lapcevic, another podium finish.
Yeah, it's definitely, I want to say it's not what we wanted, but it's definitely good for the points. No Regin, closer and closer to that top side of the podium. You know, it was a wild race, but I couldn't have got here without all my sponsors. Ace Services, Cathcart Trucking, Springer's Meats, Troy Cove Marine, Epic Raceway, JSL Electric, and all the guys back at the shop just put in a ton of hours to get us here in this last-minute call. But, you know, we're heading in the right direction, and it's definitely something we can be proud of.
Imagine, he's starting to sound disappointed with podium finishes, but that smile says it all. Alex Tagliani taking home the trophy here today. The Alberta Has New Energy 300 has been brought to you by E3 Spark Plugs, born to burn. By Leland Industries, a proud Canadian fastener company. And by Honeygoo from CleanFlow, one honey of a lube.
Short track racing at its finest. There's bruised race cars and bruised egos, Dave, but one down, one to go.
The next race will be in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan. For Todd and Adam, I'm Dave Bradley. All of us at Fuel Media Lab. We'll see you next time.
This copyrighted telecast may not be reproduced, retransmitted, or used in any form without the authorized written consent of NASCAR Broadcasting. NASCAR would like to thank all of our fans for your support, and we hope you enjoy today's broadcast.